Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to RTC TV. My name is Dakota Hayden, joined here by Galen Rensler.
Hello, hello.
And we will be your commentators for tonight's game against the Pioneer Panthers and the Caston Comets. We're here at Pioneer tonight in their home turf of the Pit, and this should be a really interesting matchup tonight between the two rival teams.
Caston wins tonight's toss. They will receive it to start tonight's competition.
And with the coin toss, Caston will be receiving and start off the game tonight.
They're getting everything here started. Get the kickoff going here.
Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, multiple chance to win. We got our signed football tonight. Tickets are $1 a piece. Six for $5. Also, we got the Buffalo Wild Wings third quarter kick. Third quarter kick for Buffalo Wild Wings. Go on down and get your tickets for that. Winner for the football being announced at halftime.
Looks like Caston set up and received the ball here as Pioneer kicks it off.
Well, that would be the way how we start it.
Nussbaum will be set to kick for Pioneer.
It seems like so far just cloudy skies tonight. No rain, hopefully, considering we're outside for tonight's game.
Yeah, I looked at the forecast earlier. It's only supposed to rain around 9 o'clock. If it does, there's a possibility at 9 o'clock.
We should be good then.
So, yeah, we should be pretty good throughout the night here in Royal Center. Pioneer, they've made it to semi-state, the past 3 years in football?
I think so,
yeah. 1A. Here a couple weeks ago, they beat Lewis Cass. Lewis Cass is a pretty big school.
Oh,
and he's brought down at the 20-yard line.
Forrest and Kaiser hit on the stop for Pioneer.
What do you think we'll see tonight for the Comets as Hartman for the quarterback, junior quarterback, and Casey Ault, the junior running back for the Comets here?
I think we're going to see a good game tonight. It's definitely going to be a tough one for the Comets,
yeah,
considering Pioneer's past. But I think they have enough in them to pull out a win. They should be a pretty good team this year.
And handoff play. He stopped.
Hartman, the ball carrier.
Might have got 1 yard on the play, but
Danny Gregory, gentlemen, stopped for Pioneer. Gain of 2 yards on the play.
Gained 2 yards on the play there. Ault did.
Second down, 8 yards to go for the pass.
Got Tate Cowell out by the right receiver spot. That's Tate Cowell, right? Number 12? Or is he number 7? Tate Cowell's number 7.
Tate is number 7.
Okay.
12 is Zach Conrad.
Ault, okay. The ball carrier.
He's brought down, lost.
Gregory, get on the stop.
Lost of yards right there. That's going back about 2 or 3 yards for the Comets.
Gain of a yard on the play.
Comets are not getting anywhere. I think that's going to be a real big struggle for the Comets tonight because Pioneer, they're just big physically.
It's definitely going to be an interesting matchup tonight.
Yeah.
But I have faith. I think the Comets might pull out a win.
Yeah.
Although I'm not going to speak too loudly here, considering
handoff play. No, quarterback takes off running. He's
Hartman, the ball
considering
carrier.
We are
he's
really
down.
Deep in Pioneer territory tonight.
That's going to force fourth down for the Comets with
Nye's also into the stop for Pioneer.
What two? It's going to be 5 yards to go, maybe.
Gain of 3 yards on the play.
Yeah, so we got
fourth down
with 4 yards to go for the Comets here.
That's totally makeable.
Looks like they're set up as in the punt. You're going to punt the ball off the Pioneer. Looks like we have a timeout called by the Panthers.
Yep, we're going to be going on timeout. We'll be right back with you after this little break.
Maddox. Have you guys noticed that? Like, when they tackle one of our players, like, they bring him down. Yeah. And there's always three guys so far.
And we're back with the timeout completely over.
We got fourth down and 4 yards to go here for the Comets. They're set up here as in the punt. Ready to get the ball punted off to Pioneer Panthers.
Kind of interesting for a timeout to be
Looks
called
like
this early on
Tate
in the game.
No, that's not Tate Callis. Who's number three?
Number three is now Phoenix Singleton.
Okay.
Sporting a new jersey, retiring the old 52.
And it looks like they're
going to
let
now.
The Comets touch the ball right at the 35-yard line.
So the down by Trent Howard.
Pretty interesting to see what Pioneer. I haven't done much research on Pioneer, if they're much of a passing team or a running team. I think you'll see a lot of both, honestly.
I feel like most of their plays are similar to ours, so it's going to be a complete going back and forth with
back
the similar
forth
plays.
Huh.
Well, that's from what I heard, but.
I guess we'll find out here, see what they do here on the first play. Ball's on the 35-yard line.
Pioneer setting up for the offense. It looks like a pass.
Pass play.
Caught.
It's complete.
And they're going to run it in for a touchdown.
And that's going to be a touchdown for the Comet, for the Panthers.
And as you can hear, the Panthers are extremely loud tonight supporting another team. Unfortunately for the video crew and I, we're stuck in deep Pioneer territory here as we're trying to get all this footage out to you.
And like we see, we saw a pass play that started off and they got it. 65-yard pass run there by the Panthers. Here they are set up as a field goal. One thing I've noticed is that they got good field goal kickers. They can kick the field goals. And that's good for the Panthers.
Extra point by Newsbaum is good.
And that's going to set the Panthers up 7-0 real early on in the first quarter.
All right, let's see what the Comets can do on this offensive run here.
They got to figure something out because if the Pioneer can keep throwing out those plays, we're going to have one heck of a time tonight.
Yeah, I think the only choice for the Comets tonight is to figure out their passing game. I don't think the running game is going to be too effective tonight just because of Panthers' physical size on the defense. And I think if the Comets are going to get some gain of yards, I think they're going to have to look to pass more here.
That's what I would think, too.
And that's something that they're not really strong at either, because the last couple games, as you've seen, they've run the ball a lot to KCL. And that's going to be a, you know, they're going to have to change something up here.
I've heard they've done a lot of practice the past week, so maybe they got some new plays up that they're about ready to test out. I don't know. We'll have to find out.
And the kick is off. And the ball is caught at the 35-yard.
And it looks like Casey was right on top of that, number 40.
Kansas starts first and 10 for their own 25-yard line.
Comets will start the ball here on the 35-yard line. As you can see, it looks like quite a few Comet fans came out here to support the Comets.
Mm-hmm. Yep, from our excellent vantage point from the other side of the field.
Rushier flips it over, gets up to the 30, maybe 27-yard line for the Comets.
Pass complete to Holt.
Looked as maybe as if Hartman was going to take off running with it. Then he found number 40 all.
1 yard on the play brings up second down for Caston.
To pick up 2 yards.
Comets setting back up for the offensive here.
Be here second down with 9 yards to go here for the Comets. It looks like a false start. I think that is on the Comets.
False start.
Yep.
Against Caston.
That's going to back him up. 5 yard penalty. That's going to back it up to the 14 yard line.
Getting a little too eager for their own good.
Oh, no. Excuse me for that. Ball's on the 21 yard line. I was looking at the yards to go. Looks like another false start by the Comets. That's going to back them up by another 5 yards.
They're just too eager for their own good here.
5 yard penalty.
Longtime rival between these two teams. They're just ready to go at it.
Between 19 yards to go for the Comets and second down.
Timeout. Caston.
Timeout called from Caston. We're going to take a short break here, and we'll be right back with you for the first quarter.
All right, welcome back. We got second down here for the Comets. 19 yards to go. Ball on the 16-yard line.
Comets still down 7-0. Not a lot has changed.
Handoff play the all, and all is stopped immediately down by the Panthers.
Panthers running a pretty good defense tonight.
No gain on the play.
There was no gain of yards on that play.
We'll make it third down for Caston.
We're here third down for the Comets with 19 yards still to go. No loss of yards or gain of yards. Looks like pass play. Hartman dropping back. Looking, scrambling. He is brought down. And that's going to force fourth down for the Comets.
This is not looking good at all.
Jason Bush. Loss of 9 yards on the play brings up fourth down for Caston.
They'll bring up fourth down for the Comets. 28 yards to go on fourth down. Looks like the Comets are here in the punt.
Not to punt
the ball off. Phoenix Singleton has the kick.
There's a nice kick by Phoenix.
Yeah. And up to the 40, 45.
And he's wide open.
40, 30, 20.
Guys with the punt return.
Up to the 20-yard line, Panthers.
Taken down by Trent Howard.
Trent Howard with the stop. Brings him down.
Pioneer start. First and goal.
Pioneer starting off on the offensive at first and goal. This is just not looking too good for the Comets right now. And the Panthers taking up the offensive.
Let's see what the Panthers would do here. Handoff play to the fullback. And he's brought down. Touchdown for the Panthers.
That's going to put it up.
This is honestly going to be a long night for the Comets. This is just the first quarter, and there's still 6 minutes to go. What do you say, Dakota? What's your thoughts right now?
I'm not sure what to think right now, Galen. It's just not looking good right now. I have all the faith in the world for Comets, but this is a really rough start. And it's good.
Extra point by Nussbaum is good.
And the kick is good for the Panthers, and that's going to be 14. Comets trail by 14 points.
Comets setting up for the defense here. And we've seen in the past games, Comets have been able to secure a pretty decent defense. Oh, wait, no, my bad. They're setting up to get the offense. I went completely backwards on that one, folks. Sorry. I forgot that the Panthers were first in goal last round, so completely threw me off there. Over the past week, the Comets have been practicing their offensive game, so let's hope it can come into play here. Even though we're still, you know, 6 minutes into the first quarter.
I will have to say that the Comets have a way better football field than the Panthers.
I'll have to agree to you with that one. That's why they call it the pit.
Yeah. Call it the pig pit.
The Panthers kickoff. Received by number 35, Colton Wilker.
Caston has some good people working that are always constantly working on the field. And that's one of them, Don King. He's always making sure that the field looks as best as it can. And he
good old Don King.
He does an amazing job. So thank you to Don Keene for keeping our field really nice and groomed up and always ready for game days, home game days. All right, ball's on the 40-yard line here for the Comets. Hand off
to number 21, Efren.
Efren goes up, and he's brought down to the 45-yard line.
Gainage of yards there.
Forced out of bounds by Bob Tobel. Gained 3 yards
on the play. Second down, 7 to go. The Comets go again for another offensive play. Looks like
handoff. Wait, I don't think that was all. Okay, that was all. Okay.
Yeah.
Might have picked up one or two on the play.
I'd say one. It didn't look like he got too far.
Hey, Chris, if you're watching, I'm using this reference for my application. Go ahead.
Keith Nye's able to stop the Pioneer. Gain of yard brings up third down.
We're going to be reaching up third down for Comets. Looks like.
And he's brought down. Loss of 5 yards there.
Boy, vey.
That's going to be fourth down for the Comets.
Loss of 5 yards on the play brings up fourth down.
What do you say, Dakota? Do you think they'll go for it here, or do you think they'll just punt the ball off?
Well, with that kind of a loss of yards, I think they're just going to punt it off.
Yeah, me too.
I mean, I got all the faith in the world.
Wait, nope, maybe not. Looks like they're going to go for it here, which is pretty crazy.
Well, you need that occasionally, a couple crazy maneuvers to get the job done. Unfortunately, tonight, it didn't get the job done.
How about Skeet to the ball carrier?
I think that was honestly a bad call by the Comets. I don't know why they would run the ball when it's fourth down.
Well, you never know until you try, I guess.
I mean, you got to at least go for something. I mean, 11 yards to go.
Jason Mershon on the stop for Pioneer.
Can't run the ball.
Give or take.
Turnover on down. Pioneer takes over first and 10 for the Caston 38-yard line.
Pioneer's going to take over on the offensive on the 38-yard line, if my eyes don't deceive me. Comets still down, 14 to zip. Looks like a pass. Pass play.
Oh, an incomplete pass by the Panthers.
Slightly over the target there.
That's going to force second down here. Second down here for the Panthers with 10 yards to go.
Brings up second down, Pioneer.
Setting up for the play.
And off
again.
Play.
Oh.
And he's going up to the 30.
He's nine, the ball carrier.
29-yard line.
Halt in on the stop.
There was a really nice tackle there. I didn't catch the number. I think it was number 20. I think Brady had that one. I'm starting to feel a little rain, Galen. I don't know about you, but if that picks up, that's going to spell trouble for us.
Yeah. I think this is the hardest it's rained. It's sprinkled a little bit before the game started. I think this is the hardest it's been. Just now starting, umbrellas are starting to come out here on the Panther side and also on the Comet side.
A handoff
and
by
off
the Panthers,
play again, and he's up
straight
to
the
defense.
It's going to be first down for Pioneer. And the Pioneer crowd definitely making sure we know about it. Setting up again. About 4.5 minutes left in the first quarter. Pass by Pioneer.
Pass play, finds him, and he's
brought down.
Brought down at the, I can't tell. I can't really see where he stopped at. Maybe the 7-yard line?
I can't tell.
For a Pioneer! Welker in on the stop for Caston. The first and goal from the 6-yard line for Pioneer.
Pioneer once again first and goal. Helmet's got to stop him right here. We can't let him get too much of a lead. Ooh.
Nice, the ball carrier.
And number 40,
all
Casey.
Always brought down.
Halt into the stop for Caston.
Nice stop by Casey.
He lost a 4 yards on the play.
That's a good defense play by Ault.
He was able to get through and take down the ball carrier and make him lose yards. That's always helpful.
Brings it back by 4. Helps the Comets out quite a bit.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Three minutes left in the first quarter. Panthers setting up.
And off play. He's
up. Handoff.
Got up to the 8-yard line. Still first down and goal for the Panthers. That will force third down with 7 yards to go.
3 yards on that play. Brings up third down, Pioneer.
Ball on the 7-yard line. It still ran here at the pit.
Oh, Getting a little wet.
It's actually really starting to pour down too. Looking for the pay.
It goes
pass.
For a pass. Where is he going?
That is overthrown.
He was aiming for that guy out there on the other side of the fence. That was way out there.
That's going to force fourth down here for the Panthers with 7 yards to go.
Fourth down and goal for Pioneer.
Here's hoping the Comets can keep them back here.
Do you think they'll kick the field goal, or do you think, because I know they have kickers.
Oh, yeah, that's obvious. They got kickers. I'm not sure.
It looks like they're going for it. They're going for the TD. And looks like timeout call. Panthers call timeout. We'll be right back after this short break.
I mean, come on, it was way off. He was like two guys over to the right. No. No. Only you shook me all night long.
All right, here we are back. Welcome once again to RTC TV. Still in the first quarter with about 2.5 minutes left to go. Comets still trailing by 14 points, but so far I've been able to hold them back from scoring another touchdown.
The Panthers are going for it here on fourth down. Ooh, got away from Phoenix. Throws it into the end zone. That's a touchdown.
That's going to be another touchdown for Pioneer. Here they are setting up for the field goal. And I'm no betting man, but I'm going to bet that it's good.
It's good.
And that'll put the Comets back 21 points.
Just in the first quarter, there's still 2 minutes to go here.
I'm really hoping this isn't how it's going to be the rest of the night, or else it's going to be.
That's going to be really brutal for the Comets.
It is.
Long night ahead of them.
I don't know. I'm still going to keep faith for them. They seem pretty confident going into the matchup tonight. Whereas they claimed it was war week, so training was all tough this week.
Deuce Bob set to kick for Pioneer.
Pioneer sets up to kick it off to Comets.
Efren Emesquito is set back to return the ball here for the Comets. Alt to his left, to his right, excuse me. Looks like Alt's going to catch the ball, and he's going to return up to the 30-yard line. He stopped at the 29. Looks like he lost the ball there, then Danny Gringridge recovered it there.
And then took quite a few people to take him down. And Comets setting up for the offensive. Before the first quarter ends, Comets got a score.
Back, Handoff play the alt. Alt is stopped at the picked up 2 yards on the carry. Be here second down for the Comets. With I think 8 yards to go.
I think.
I don't know. I don't think he picked up it. Okay, he picked up 1 yard.
So 9 yards to go. Pioneers defense acting like a stone wall so far. It's only the first quarter. Still. Hand off to Casey again.
Oh, the ball carrier.
Might have gained a yard.
Kevin Hines into the stop for
ball will be on the 33-yard line here for the Comets. Third down with 7 yards to go.
Ooh, he picked up 2 yards.
So they picked up something there.
Yeah.
They're
better
getting somewhere.
Better than nothing.
They're getting there. Let's see what they do here on third down. Looking for a big pass play here. And Brady's looking for someone. And he that fumble loses the ball. And he is out of bounds. That's going to force fourth down here for the Comets.
Quarterback sacked by Danny Gregorich. Fumbled out of bounds.
And less than a minute left to go.
Loss of 7 yards on the play. Fourth down for Caston.
Comets can't do much here, but punt it back to the Panthers. Unless they want to go risky, but they're not going to. We already learned last time what happened.
Looks like he's
was not.
Also, Pierce is going to return that and catch that. I thought maybe he might have just let it drop. But
a little sprite of rain must have made his hands slippery.
47-yard line.
Or made the ball slippery.
Either way. It almost looked like back there, number 3, Phoenix almost took the head off of one of the Pioneer guys going for him. He did get tackled, though.
Okay, I didn't see that.
Hand off by Pioneer, and he just breaks through the Comets defense.
He's going up.
He is way out there.
And that's going to be a touchdown. Panthers.
And the first quarter isn't even over yet. And with 21 seconds to go.
And that's the second time. The Panthers' first play possession and goes for a touchdown. The first one was a pass play to start off the game. And then now we see a first play run, and he goes right through the Caston's defense and goes into the end zone.
It's just not good. This is just not good. Someone needs to keep track of how many times I say that, because so far this just is not good.
Looks to be maybe there's a
offside. But,
okay, Caston's offsides there.
That's exactly what you mean, offside.
Panthers setting up for the field goal again. The kick, and that's going to be good. Got to hand it to him. They can kick.
Kind of games where you just wing it because it doesn't really matter what you say. You don't really say anything.
Nothing. Well, 21 seconds left for the first quarter. Comets down 28 points.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy. Panthers scoring 28 points in the first quarter. I mean, that's crazy.
At this point, I'm just hoping we score. Maybe once. Is that too much to ask? I hope not. Comets all set up to receive the kickoff from the Panthers. Yeah, we got it all set up here. And fire away.
Oh, gets the return. He's up to 20 and 35 yard line for the Comets.
Alt takes the kickoff.
That's a good return by Alt.
Yeah, every little bit helps.
Derek Wireman in the stop for Pioneer.
16 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Comets trail by 28.
Caston starts first and 10 from their own 36 yard line.
You know, I do believe the Comets have yet to make a first down here.
That is true. They have not got a first down yet.
Just give us four more.
Here we go, set up for the offensive.
Handoff play the Alt to Mosquito. He's brought down. And that's going to take us into the second quarter. We will be right back after this short break. Thank you for tuning in to RTC TV4. Be sure to check out our website, rtctv4.com. Thank you.
For improv on jokes here, like seriously. I thought they were playing the VeggieTales theme songs. What are they doing? Oh, they are doing this. Can we do that? Can we do that? I want to do that. I want to see someone with like a sousaphone do that. I am. They look like they're having a great time. Both. You want to bring him back? You want me to do it?
All
right, welcome back to RTC TV. In case you forgot, my name's Dakota Hayden alongside with Galen Rensler. And Comets all set to take out the offensive as we start up the second quarter here. Still trailing by 28 points.
All the ball carrier.
And it looks like the handoff was made to Casey, but he got pushed back. There was at least three to four guys just destroyed him.
So Gavin James into the stop for Pioneer. Loss of 3 yards on the play. Third down, 12 yards to go for Caston.
Bring up second down here for the Comets. No, third down, excuse me, on that one. Third down for the Comets, 12 yards to go. Ball's on the 34-yard line. Let's see what the Comets can do on this position. We'll be right back after this short break. Thanks for tuning in to RTC TV4.
Right here, dude, I got you. Throw me a shirt. I want it. Give me.
Donated by Knievel Insurance Agency right here in Royal Center. For all your insurance.
I got it.
Welcome back to RTC TV 4. Comets have the ball on the 34-yard line. Third down. Looks like a handoff to all, and he's brought down here at the 39-yard line.
They're just pointing them out and swarming them. They're all black and white like a bunch of bees swarming to the kill. But bees don't kill. That's the funny part.
They sting.
They do sting.
And it does hurt. Even though I've never got stung by a bee before.
Really?
Yeah. Pretty thankful for that. So I don't know if I'm allergic to them or not. Hopefully not.
Hopefully.
I pray not.
No Pioneer taking the offensive here. It's like a handoff play.
Guys, the ball carrier. All in on the stop forecasted.
I'm actually surprised that the Panthers, they don't call themselves the Pioneer Bumblebees. Because their uniforms actually do look like Bumblebees.
They do.
I think it'll be better, too. I like it a lot better than the Panthers.
I don't know. It seems like to be a really long tradition of being called the Panthers. I wouldn't think they'd change their names now.
I mean, just saying, like, what if they were? Like,
that'd be. I could see them going
Pioneer
along
with Bumblebees.
It. Flag on the play.
False start, Pioneer.
Oh, false start for Pioneer.
5 yard penalty.
We'll take all the help we can get for that one. Here we go, setting back up again. However, I have a really bad feeling in the pit of my stomach that they're going to make up those 5 yards
and
soon.
And off play again, and he stopped.
Guys are the ball carrier. Trent Howard in on the stop forecasting.
That's a nice stop by number 53, Trent Howard.
Trent Howard's been pretty good on the defensive end. He's gotten pretty good a couple stops to help the Comets out on the defensive end.
Short gain on the play. Brings up third down for Pioneer.
Ooh, hitting off play.
And he's just gaining all the yards.
Up to the...
And that's going to set a first down for Pioneer.
John Mitchell in on the stop forecasting.
Ball will be on what? I think 14th. Okay, I was going to say 15. So, hands it off. He's still going. He's up to the 10.
It's up. Pushed
guys,
out.
He's brought down. I think he picked up 4 on the game.
You know, it's funny. When we do the run plays, we get stopped. But when they do the run plays, they gain quite a few yards.
Yeah. Like I said, I mean, Panthers are really, really big physical, and they're really good on the defensive end. So, like I said, I mean, the Comets are going to have to try to figure something out, maybe try out the passing game. But even though when they tried out the passing game, they're always rushing. They're blitzing on them. So, that didn't really work out either. I guess it's just they're going to have to just, you know, work through it, I guess.
Something's got
to
be done here.
And I think he's first and goal for the Pioneer. But here, first and goal for the Panthers on the 1 yard line. Ball on the 1 yard line for the Panthers.
This is no bueno. Pioneer setting up. And it looks like is he gonna go for a pass? He went for a pass.
Finds him in the middle. Ooh,
and it was a complete
pass.
That
would be a touchdown.
Number 2, Jacob Murray.
kind of fumbled it a little bit, then manages to hang on to it. He got scores the touchdown.
This is disappointing. I'm gonna just go ahead and say that they got 35-0. They're gonna make this field goal. If they don't, I'm gonna be shocked and amazed.
And the field goal is good.
Point by Newsbaum is good.
I still have faith. You know, at this point, even though it's only the second quarter, I'm still calling if we at least score one touchdown, I'm going to be happy. At least one. That's all I ask. There's going to be a comeback like no other. I'm feeling it. I'm feeling the vibes.
What kind of vibes are you feeling?
I'm feeling the good vibes, Galen. I'm feeling that we're going to make some kind of roaring comeback out of nowhere.
Honestly, I do not know what vibes mean. Like, what does vibes mean?
It's a feeling.
It's a feeling?
You got a good feeling. You got good vibes. You got a good feeling.
Maddox, our film guy. Maddox, what do you think that what vibes mean?
I have no idea.
Same.
I see. I'm the only one out here then.
Dakota is a little different, but different's okay.
Thank you, Galen.
Dakota, you're a good guy.
You too, Galen. You too.
For the comments.
And might as well, since we introduced him, a little quick shout-out to our camera guy sitting right next to us on this lovely evening at the Pioneer Pit. Thanks, Maddox.
Oh, he's brought down. Oh, yeah.
Olt's leg just get taken out right underneath
him.
He's
right down. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, he got knee done.
He's asking for a shout-out. Caston starts first and 10 for their own 20-yard line.
Comets setting up to once again take the offensive. Hopefully this time he gets somewhere.
Yeah, let's see what the Comets can do on this position.
I still
have handoff play. The alt is brought down.
There was like five of them.
It's like that every time five guys was bringing down one of the Comets offensive guys. There's always at least three guys.
Garrett Schroeder in on the stop for Pioneer.
That's ridiculous. We got 8 minutes left in the second quarter. It looks like
he's trying to go for a pass play, and he just takes off running. Because no one's open.
He was getting surrounded. There was not really.
As you can see, number 12, Conrad. Conrad was all the way over to the 50, 45-yard line. Hartman was over to the far side of the 10-yard line. It's like, I don't know why you would be way over there when, first of all, Hartman cannot throw that far. Honestly. You need to come back. Even though you're supposed to run that route, you need to come back and at least try to get open instead of running away from the quarterback.
I don't know, dude.
Here we go, ball on the 19-yard line here for the Comets.
They send up
pass play.
Short pass to.
And he's brought down.
Pass
hard
that
hit. That was to Ephraim, number 21.
That's gonna force fourth down here for the Comets.
They should go for it. They should definitely go for it. All or nothing. Go for it.
I mean, what do they got to lose? It's 35-0.
They have absolutely nothing to lose. That's why they should go for it. And it looks like they are good.
No, it looks like they're in the punt. They're
going to
play
off.
Like I said, in the North Johnson game, Dakota does have some eye issues. he got mixed up last game. And he's still – wait, Dakota, have you went to the eye doctor since?
These are high-quality HD glasses, Galen. Okay. I want to say I can see clearly, but you know what? That looked like a decent kick from Phoenix.
Yeah.
Personal foul against Pioneer.
It looks like Pioneer's getting hit with a personal foul.
Number 40. Who's number 40? It's not Slocum, is it?
No, number 40 for us is Casey.
Oh, yeah, Casey. Okay.
44 is
Zach the running back. Okay. What do you think of Zach Slocum this game? I haven't really seen him do that much. He must be... I don't know. What do you think he's doing? I haven't seen anything from him yet.
I haven't seen him either. He's around there somewhere.
Yeah.
15-yard penalty. Ball spotted on the 35. First and 10.
End off.
End off. He's got yards. Go, Efren.
Hart with the ball carrier.
No, that was Hart.
Okay.
That was Brady. That was number 20,
Once
Brady.
Once gets taken off, he can get pretty fast.
Carries enough for a Caston first down.
Apologies to Brady. I saw the two, and I assumed it was Efren. And that's going to be the first down that I think we've had this game.
Hey, well, hey, look. I think that's the first Caston's first down right there.
I'm pretty sure, yeah. They go for another pass.
Oh,
incomplete
pass.
Good thing that went out, because if that went any lower, that would have been an interception, and that would have been very bad. We got about a little less than 6 minutes left here in the second quarter. I'd have to say so far it's running a little smoother, maybe. I don't know. Pioneer's only scored once this quarter, so I'd say it's going pretty smoothly. A handoff play. Number 40, Casey. Nice gainage of some yards there.
Ball carrier.
We should have gained it.
And as you can tell, this is definitely an intense matchup tonight.
Yeah,
did you just say an intense matchup?
This is as intense as it gets. Just the sheer rivalry of it all. Short pass to Efren and is immediately ran out.
That's all the passing that they've been doing so far. They just throw it off to one of the side.
Lost 3 yards side, on the play.
Running back, there's...
Makes it a fourth down.
That's going to be a fourth down for the Comets. I want them, of course, it doesn't matter what I want them to do. It'd be nice if they went risky a little bit here, but that's probably not going to happen. I still have faith, though. I still have faith. Something's going to happen. We're going to have the biggest comeback of the century.
I told Hartman, the quarterback for the Comets, before the game, I told him I want to see a Hail Mary. So we'll
I want to see that. That'd
he
be awesome.
He kind of shook his head, so there's probably a high possibility he will not. But maybe, I don't know. We'll see.
I don't know. But the refs called a timeout, so we're going to be right back with you after the break here. Thanks again for tuning in to RTC TV. Do ya? We're in a Caston shirt freaking conversion right there. Nope. Hey, you want to bring him back in?
He
can't
since he's heard it.
All right, I got it. All right, welcome back. We're still in the second quarter with about 5 minutes left to go as Caston still has the offensive here on their fourth down, and it looks like they're going to go for it. I'm happy to see that. Pass by Brady, and it looked complete, but Efren took a really big hit from the back.
Harvin's pass falls incomplete.
Oh, it's incomplete.
Jack Conger what? In on the coverage for Pioneer.
He didn't catch it. What?
Turnover on downs.
Yes, that'll be a turnover on down for the Comets, and the Panthers would take possession of the offensive end.
My glasses are very dirty. No wonder I can't see some obvious stuff like that. Ugh. I do know one thing, and I don't need my glasses to see that. Pioneer is taking the offensive once again. And it looks like he's...
Flag is thrown out onto the field.
No flagging.
Flag on the play.
I don't know if that's on the Comets or the Panthers there. I would say maybe it's on the Panthers.
Yeah, they called it on the Panthers, yep. That's going to help. Every little bit counts.
5-yard penalty.
That'll get the Panthers for 15 yards to go now.
First down to 15 yards to go here for the Panthers.
Looks like a handoff play. Comets defense able to stack him up and bring him down. Small yard gainage, only 3 yards, I think. Yeah, that one 3 yards.
Gaining 3 yards on the play. He's second down, Pioneer.
Beer second down here for the Panthers. We got 12 yards to go. Ball on the 46-yard line.
It looks like Pioneer's going a little bit slow on the offensive this time around, which is a good thing. But probably jinxed us now, I said that.
Hand off play, he's up to the 45, 50-yard line. He's stopped.
Heard a loud clank out there of helmets.
That sounded like a pretty hard hit by the Comets. I could hear the hit up here.
Made it 5 yards on the play.
And about 3.5 minutes left for the second
down,
quarter.
7 yards to go for Pioneer.
As we approach halftime. Panthers back set up on the offensive. Comets defense really got pulled through here.
Pass play here by Panthers. Panthers going deep. Oh!
Incomplete.
There's just a little, I guess it was just a little ball, but the pass was a little too high.
Couldn't jump that high. What a shame.
Hint, hint, get in the weight room.
Which, speaking of weight rooms, the Comets definitely own one of the best weight rooms around.
That is definitely true.
Kaiser in punt formation.
It looks like Pioneer's going to punt it right back off.
Deep to receive for the Comets.
Looks like it's starting the rain here back at the pit.
Umbrellas just pouring out everywhere. Something.
Panthers going for it, fourth down.
Panthers a major.
Kaiser the ball carrier. Cool for a Pioneer.
That's going to put a first down on the Pioneer. For Pioneer. And it looks like there's a bunch of rain coming through. We might have to cut out here soon if it starts picking up any harder. So if we cut out, just know that we're trying to get all the gear in safe, folks.
Which is now.
And it looks like we're going to have to cut it here, folks. The rain's pouring down pretty hard. We're going to go and get under some cover. Thanks for tuning in to RTC TV. If it starts to let up, we'll come back. But until then, thanks for watching. And we're back. Welcome back to RTC TV. We're a generous ways into the third quarter. The rain started to let up, which allows us to get back onto the air here. And I'll tell you, you haven't really missed much except for, you know, Pioneer scored a few more points and Caston's still stuck at a zero. But I still have faith. I think something's going to happen here.
Well, Dakota, I have to say that it's great that you still have faith for the Comets and when it's 49-0.
Never going to give up, dude. We're in it to win it. Even when it looks like we're definitely going to lose it.
Thinking of Minute to Win It, have you ever watched that show, Minute to Win It? Ever seen that?
Oh, yeah, I've seen
that show. That was a lot of fun. I like watching that. It's like some of those like really cool shows, like they go away, they're only on for like a certain time period. It's like I wish they would stay.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Oh, fumble!
Recovered by Pioneer.
Fumble recovered by Kaiser.
Bay here, third down for the Panthers with 9 yards to go.
Off the 7 yards.
Yep. They're doing pretty well for themselves. Just now, less than 5 minutes into the third quarter. Panthers getting ready to take on the offensive.
How many points do you think the Panthers will score?
Well, considering they're at 49 now, they made...
Ooh, complete pass there.
Complete pass there, maybe. Yeah, that was...
Pass complete to Nate Johnson.
Yeah, that was complete.
All right, so how much would you say they'll score?
I hate to bet against my own team, but same. I'm thinking they're going to get into the 60s.
I'm going to say that they'll hit 80. That's what I'm going to say. They'll hit 80.
Yeah.
Sadly, though. But
I'm just hoping we at least score once.
Yeah.
That's all I want to see.
Handoff play, and he's up to the...
Nate Johnson, the ball carrier. John Mitchell in on the stop forecast.
Yeah, go John Mitchell. He's doing a great job there on the defensive line. And I mean that seriously. Like, you're pretty good.
Bring up second down.
Once again, thanks for tuning in to RTC TV4. Be sure to check out our website, www.rtctv4.com. You can find a lot of videos of high school sports. And this year, we're covering all Caston sports, home games and away games. Basketball, football, volleyball, varsity boys basketball, varsity girls basketball. So be sure to tune in there, and you can also check us out on the Facebook page also by just by typing in RTC TV4 Rochester, and should be able to find us on there, like us, and be updated, stay alert with us, and watch your favorite high school team play.
Nice ball carrier.
And at the end of that shameless self-advertisement there, we heard, I think we're getting told that we heard sirens in the distance, so if we have to cut out short, there's a good explanation behind it. But I think we should be fine.
I guess there was a tornado warning.
There was a watch.
There's a watch, okay. But we haven't really seen anything, and I think we're pretty good for the night, unless it starts raining again. But
yeah, there's been some sparks here and there.
I think we're all right.
But we'll keep our ears and eyes open, that's for sure. And there is a major gainage at yards there by the Pioneer.
Trent Howard with another stop for the Comets. Like I said earlier, Trent Howard, number 53, the senior, he's been doing really great on the defensive end for the Comets, and that's the ginger milkshake that I was talking about in the first home opener.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, Trent Howard, I call him the ginger milkshake.
That's a good nickname for him. It looks like Pioneer fumbled down there.
Nice, the ball carrier.
you can only always look forward to a safety. Especially if Conrad's hard.
Fumble recovered by
and it looks like Caston recovered that fumble.
Wow.
Nice.
Kind of surprising there. I wasn't really expecting that, but what can you expect in high school football?
I'm telling you, big comeback. Fourth quarter is all us.
We'll see what happens. Stay tuned. Be here third down for the Comets. I mean second down. Second down here for the Comets. 10 yards to go and the ball is on the 1 yard line. This is great. Great opportunity for the Panthers to maybe get a safety here. I don't know. What do you think, Dakota? Do you think you'll maybe get a safety here?
I'm thinking so. But we'll see what
Hey,
incomplete pass.
You see they're kind of rushing on that play. Trying to get that ball out there. It looks like the rain is starting to pick up again. We'll keep you guys updated. We might have to come back here if it. But the rain is letting loose here.
Yeah.
We'll keep you guys updated. So far, we're okay.
For now. So far, we're decently sheltered, but it is pouring. That came out of nowhere.
Yeah. I don't know if you can see in the camera or not, if you can see the rain coming down. Can you see the rain coming down through there? Yeah. As you can see, it's pouring down pretty good. It's kind of like a mist, really.
Almost.
Touchdown, Pioneer!
And that's a touchdown from Pioneer. 55-0. It seems like we might have a little bit of technical difficulties. I'd like to thank you all for tuning in to RTC TV. We'll get right back to you if you can. But for right now, we're going to sign off real quick. And we're back. We were able to get that technical difficulty all sorted out. Now, we seem to have ran out of memory left on the camera that we had going for the game, so we had to cut out there briefly. But now we're back online, getting all that good footage back to you.
As you can see, the Panthers scored, and they're leading 55-0. Third quarter with 41 seconds to go here.
Caston starts first and 10 from their own 38-yard line.
Still not losing hope here. I got full confidence in the fourth quarter. The Comets setting up here for defense.
Hartman scrambling, finds Efren, and Efren goes up.
Pass complete to Amaskita.
That was my bad. The Comets were on the offensive there.
That was a hard hit right there.
And it looks like a few of the players are slipping and sliding around out there. Looks like the rain's finally got a good grip on the field here. That was some nice yard gainage by number 21, Efren. Maybe we might see some points here scored by the Comets. Maybe not. Only time will tell with only 20 seconds left in the third quarter. Come on, Comets. Yeah, just enough time to make off another play. And it looks like they're going to run out the clock to end the third quarter. Once again, we're going to thank you all for tuning in to RTC TV, and we will be right back for the fourth and final quarter of tonight's game. Thank you.
is no funny business, Milburn. This is serious. Oh, we're dying. Oh, we're dying. Oh, my leg. I have faith. As if they score 1 point, I'm going to start singing Journey. I will, on the mic.
And welcome back to RTC TV 4, just the beginning of the fourth quarter here. Comets trail by 55 points. Oh, fumble.
And Pioneer
gets
the ball.
Pioneer.
Well, that just happened. Okay,
the quarterback, junior, Brady Harmon, has to be shaken up after that play. He got hit hard in the head.
Normally, I'm pretty loyal to my team, but what do I sign up to convert to being a Panther? Just maybe for one game? I mean, I'm joking, guys, but, like, seriously. And it's good.
First point by Newsbaum. It's good. Run back touchdown by number 75, Jason Mersch.
Well, folks, I tell you, this has been one eventful game. We've had tornado watches, random rain showers, a lot of scoring tonight. I still have faith. I think the Comets can pull through here. This is like a scoring 63 points. You know, that's never been done before in one quarter, but I think we could pull something off here. I believe in miracles.
Comet fans are still in the stands, so they haven't left yet, so that's a pretty good sign, wouldn't you think, Dakota?
Oh, yeah. They haven't given up hope, and neither will I. Fourth quarter, all the way. Pioneer's going to kick this ball off to the Comets, and they're going to run it back straight for a touchdown. It's a nice kick. Casey's got it.
Oh, it was down at the 25-yard line.
If one of the guys besides the Panther goes past the
ball. Wyatt Felker in on the stop for Pioneer.
They need to be penalized for that. I've seen them do it like 20 times now.
Caston starts first and 10. They're on 26-yard line.
I'll be on the 26-yard line here for the Comets as they start off their offensive position. Hand off the alt, and alt's down right at the 28-yard line.
This is just brutal.
Justin Sparks in on the tackle. Gain of 2 yards on the play brings up second down.
Come on, Comets. Miracles can happen.
Right off play, the
Singleton, the ball carrier.
Singleton, they handed the ball off to Singleton. I've never seen him run the running back position before.
He ran it back. He did that at West Central a few times. Of course, I did solo commentary that game, but I saw him do it a few times.
Okay.
So nothing completely new there.
Okay, so yeah, so that's just my first time seeing him run the running back.
The Comets ready to look
looking
for a
pass.
And
that's incomplete
overshoots.
Pass.
Hartman's pass to Jennifer Welker falls incomplete. Bring a fourth down for Caston.
Let's go risky. They're not going to go risky. But I mean, at this point, what do you got to lose? Phoenix is set up to kick the ball back to the Pioneer Panthers, and he does so. Nice kick.
Nice kick by Phoenix Singleton.
Put it down by Welker. Pioneer starts first and 10.
Pioneer lines up there to take the offensive.
They're on 38-yard line.
With only about 10 minutes left in the fourth quarter. First and 10 for him. And Pioneer's going to call a timeout. We're going to take a real short break here. We'll get right back to you afterwards.
Considering we don't play Rochester, and Rochester rocks the black and gold.
They do?
Yeah. I don't think we play Rochester. We don't play Rochester, do we?
We don't play football.
Yeah, see, normally they would rock the red and, I mean, the gold and black, because I don't think they go by yellow. Everybody, shout out.
All right, welcome back to RTC TV4. Panthers have the ball on the 38-yard line. First down with 10 yards to go. Handoff play. Hey, ooh, he's Casey all with the tackle.
Going barbaric there and pushing him back some yards.
I've been noticing Casey all on the defense end for the Comets. He's one of the main guys that tries to bring. He's a good defensive guy for the Comets.
That was nice. I want to see more of that.
Also 4 yards on the play. Brings up second down.
If you can't beat him, destroy him.
It looks as if the Panthers actually stuck in mostly their JV team. So this is the Comets varsity team playing the Panthers JV team right now.
Fatal mistake made by the Panthers. We're going to destroy.
Ooh, looks like he got flipped up there.
Nice. Nice. Just brutality.
Levi Hoffman, the ball carrier.
Who did that? Who got him?
Tate Cowan on the stop.
That was nice by Tate, number 7. Just completely rammed him.
86 yards on the play. Brings up third down.
Panthers setting up for the third down. Got about 8 yards to go. Handoff. He gains yards. Ooh, but he got stopped again by Tate.
Right Montoya, the ball carrier.
I think, if I did my math right, which normally I don't, but I think that might have been about maybe a first down. Nope, they're just 1 yard short.
And it's 7 yards on the play, brings up fourth down, 1 yard to go.
I was close. Panthers setting up again for the offense. Come on, Comets.
Fourth down for the Panthers. 20 yards to go, and they pick up the first down up to the 50.
And off play. Yes. They may have got the first down, but I need to see more destruction like that. About 7.5 minutes, a little bit over 7.5 minutes left of the fourth quarter. Comets defense still holding back Pioneer as they start up again with first and 10 at the 45-yard line.
First down and 10 for the Panthers. Handoff play up to the middle, and he's getting brought down. Picks up 4 yards on the
straight up dog pile
on the handoff.
Wireman, the ball carrier. Gained 5 yards on that play.
It looks like the Panthers are going to have 5 yards to go on their second down. I'm still sticking through. There might only be 6 minutes and 40 seconds left on the clock, but I know we can do something. Something amazing. Anything, please.
Hand off play.
Montoya, the ball carrier.
He thought he could juke us. Nope. Defense holds still and puts him down on the 40-yard line.
No gain on the play. Brings up third down. 5 yards to go for Pioneer.
We've got them right where we want them. They're stuck. They're trapped. They're not going to go anywhere. Setting up for another offensive play.
All right, third down here for the Panthers. We got 5 yards to go. Handoff play up to the 40, 30. 40, 30.
And that's going to be another first down by the Pioneer.
Good for a Pioneer first down.
And it's not good for us at all. Comets defense got to hold them here. They're just slowly able to inch away at us, but we can keep them back like a stone wall. We won't break. Hand off.
Oh, and he's brought down. That's a hard hit.
It's a nice takedown there by number 8, Blake Albright, completely taking out his legs.
Blake Albright in on the tackle. Gain of 2 yards on the play. Brings up second down for Pioneer.
Pioneer's setting up again for the offensive. 8 yards to go for him. About 4 minutes and 20 seconds left on the clock.
Handoff. He's brought down. And we got 4 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter.
Gain of 3 yards on the play. Third down, 5 yards to go for Pioneer.
There's still hope left. Even though it's only 3 minutes and 45 seconds, we can do it. We can do it. It's gonna happen. It's gonna be a handoff there by Pioneer.
So I was playing and we were on the worst team in the NFL.
Wireman, the ball carrier.
And I won like 20 or something to like 7.
Because of my own stuff. We're just approaching the 3 minute mark here.
In
the fourth quarter. I'm kind of happy the rain hasn't picked up again so we can finish off here tonight.
Fourth down, 2 yards to go.
It's been eerily quiet. Only 2 yards to go for Pioneer.
Fourth down.
Handoff
play. That's a first down for the Panthers.
Montgomery with the carry. Conrad in on a stop for Caston. Carry's good for a Pioneer. First down.
That's going to be a first down for Pioneer. With about 2 minutes, approaching 2 minutes left on the clock for the fourth quarter. The handoff play by Pioneer.
We got 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter as the Panthers lead 62-0.
Well, unfortunately, I think I'm going to have to finally admit possible defeat there.
You're just now going to admit
it? There's a slight chance that I think we might have gotten beaten tonight.
Wow, Dakota. Wow.
4 yards on the play. Second down, Pioneer.
Just maybe. You know, 62-0, it's not that bad. It's not that bad. We tried. We gave it our best.
Montgomery, the ball carrier. Gavin Hickel, doing the stop.
Looks like Gavin Hickel, the freshman, got in, get some playing time there for the Comets with
awesome the
good defensive stop. He's a freshman.
Gotta make it third down, 10 yards to go.
That's Gavin Hickel for ya.
We got less than a minute on the clock. Ten yards left for Pioneer. Hit the first down. Still leading by 62. Not much has changed in the 30 seconds that it took me to tell
you
that.
And the Panthers kneel the ball, and that will be the game. That will be the ball game there.
Well, we thank you all for watching RTC TV tonight.
Final score, Caston 0, Pioneer 62.
In case you forgot, my name is Dakota Hayden, alongside with my co-partner here, Galen Rensler.
Be sure to check us out on Facebook and our website, www.rtctv4.com. You can find everything on there. So thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next Friday. I believe it will be at LaVille High School. We'll catch you next time on RTC TV 4.